Because when we use it in the Quran, we want you to know what you're saying. And that's the iwad. Iwad here means it's in place of something else. For example, when you have, and I'm just looking for some of my examples here, so I don't want to confuse anybody. In the iwad, you'll have, let's say, for example, it's coming in place of something else, not like muqabila. Okay? So here we have qadi. Okay? Qadi, right? Qadi with ya. But then we'll write it qadin. Now this tanween is in place of this ya. Okay, iwadan, in place of that ya that's right there. Does that make sense? So that's one form of iwad. Another form of iwad is when it comes in place of a thought. So it says, kullun. Let's use this. Kullun. This is another way that you can write this tanween. Let me write it for you like that. This also means these three. Okay? Kullun. Yamut. Okay, yamutu. Kullun yamutu. What this tanween means here means kullu insan. You understand? Every person dies. Kullun means every and all. This is all of kullun, kullun yamut, kullun insan, or kulluna. It could mean that too. Kulluna, all of us die. So this tanween is in place of this insan or this na right there at the end of the word. The dhamir or the actual word. Does that make sense? You sure about that? Okay, so we have that also in the Quran. وَكُلًّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah says in the Quran, وَكُلًّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. Like that. So it says كُلُّلٍ. It has an insan, wal jinn, wal male and female. Everybody. Okay, both of the peoples. Okay, so now, the last one, the one that it to me is beautiful, is when it comes, when this tanween comes in place of a whole sentence. And that's when you have the either, the sentence that starts off with either. Then, if in most cases when you see that, you'll find the yoma idhin, hima hina idhin. Okay, so let's look at that right quick. You see what I used as example. Allah says in the Quran. Oh, this pen is. فلولا إذا بلغت الحكم وأنتم حينئذٍ Hina idhin. See the tanween? Tandurun. Okay. Now, let's examine the statement. فَلَوْلَا إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذٍ تَنْظُرُونَ. Here, we have idhin. Right here, everybody see that? Idhin. The tanween here is in iwadan, is in place of this whole sentence. Allah says, falawla. If it's then not the case, if it's not like that, then either when, balagat al-hulqum, when the soul has reached the throat, wa antum, and you all, hina, at that time, idhin, hina, idhin, either what? Either balagat al-hulqum. Okay, tanzurun. Here at that time, when the soul has reached the throat, you all are standing there watching. You understand? So the idhin here is in place of not having to repeat this whole sentence here. Okay? Does that make sense? So the tanween is a representation of إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ. So you could say mentally, فَلَوْلَا إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ تَنْظُرُونَ. In Arabic, it makes sense. In English, let me try to make it some sense. So when the soul has reached the point of departure from the neck, it's coming up your throat, and you're sitting there watching at the time that the soul has reached the neck and it's about to depart, you're watching. Okay? As opposed to saying on that, then at that time, it's said. Hina even, then at that time. You got it? I see a smile. It's radical law. Okay? And that smile means fam. I understand. So that's what that tanween means. Now, we only went through all of that in order for people, for us all, to know what we're talking about. When we start talking about ahkamu noon is sakinah with tanween, we're not just talking in an abstract form. We're talking about these four types of tanween, and we're talking about all those different noon is sakinah that we just saw and how they go down. And this is just the title of the chapter. Okay? This is just the title of the chapter, and that's all we're going to deal with today. So you can sit down and soak that up. And when we come back to the next lesson, we're going to deal with the ahkam al-nun al-sakinati wa tanwini, insha'Allah ta'ala. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. See, I still got 5 minutes.